Welcome to Lando, the Peace on the Streets radio show. I'm your host, Prince of the Sun.
And your girl, Mimi.
And we got special guests.
We have Reshell Smith for Wealthy Wild Wednesday.
This is when we wild out, you guys. Yeah. And guess what? We're celebrating.
We are.
We're celebrating until they put him out the house. But some are saying he's not coming back. He got to go to Lago down there. That's where he normally spend his Christmas and bring it in down there in Miami. So they saying that when he get back, it'll be like the 4th or the 5th. But they're not predicting him to come back to the White House.
Oh, wow.
It's Mar-a-Lago. Let's start there.
Okay. Because
You know how you are. You know how you are.
I was almost there.
Yes.
We have in the house, we have to give a shout out to our sponsors.
Oh, yeah, we do. So let's make a shout out to 321 No Fault. Remember, guys, we had callers call in while we on the air. If you get involved in any sort of accident, slip, or fall, reach out to Mimi immediately.
Come on.
I can assist you legally and medically, no cost out of pocket.
Yes.
Trust me, they come in fast, and in less than 15 minutes on a phone call with qualified associates, they can release to you if you have a potential case or not.
And I like what you just said. No money out of your pocket.
Yeah, that's real.
That's big. Yeah.
And if I'm not mistaken, out of our team members, 2 or 3 are getting assisted by No Fault right now.
I am.
I don't want to be assisted by No
Fault.
I know something's got to happen, but if it does, I'll be calling 321 No Fault.
Thank you, guys.
And let me say real quick, we had a caller that called in, and I appreciate her.
Uh-huh.
I assisted her. She called me today and told me how well they treated her.
Wonderful.
She said they were so sweet.
Right.
She called me like they took such great care of me. I said, you know, I heard great things about it, and I'm really happy to hear this. This is why I'm still here.
I had a slip and fall on a Friday.
Wow.
Monday, I was laid up with doing physical therapy.
Wow, and they're still assisting you.
Yes, they are. And nice. I love my physical therapy.
Yeah.
And then my lawyer, she calls me like every once a month. Mm. She gives me a call to check and see how I'm doing.
Good.
You know, and so.
It's huge.
The case is rolling.
It's huge coming from a lawyer where they usually don't contact you.
Yeah, they
only
do.
Only if they need, they seriously need to. But for them to check up on you is a really good thing. It's hard to find.
Yes, it is.
Nice.
So I appreciate 321 No Fault.
That's it, 321 No Fault. Don't forget, guys, we also assist outside of the state, so not just Florida, but we do specify in South Florida and Orlando. So big shout out to No Fault.
Yeah. Ooh. And we have our special guest in the house, Reshell Smith. She's an MBA CFP Transition Money Coach, Ames Financial Education and Consultant, LLC, Stock Marketing Finances Insight. Is the coronavirus affecting our economy?
Did it! Those qualifications are important.
Oh, man. Because sometimes if we don't give people that credit and they do, then people just, we got anybody on here. No, I got somebody on here.
Yes, because guess what? I stayed up a long time, many, many nights, studying really, really hard, giving the people my money to take these courses and classes. And guess what? It's worth something. Mm. And you all are worth something. And that's why we have Wealthy Wild Out Wednesday.
Yes.
Thank you. Woo. So the topic is the corona affecting our economy?
We're definitely gonna talk about that, but you know what we're gonna touch on first, because it's so important, and it's what the election means to your portfolio.
Interesting.
Yes. We gotta talk about that. Gotta talk about that.
Okay, so we're gonna be coming back with Mrs. Smith.
Yes.
You know, and so what's with Nurse V?
Well, Nurse V, big shout out to Nurse V. By the way, Nurse V won't be on air tonight.
But we know what she told us to do. Social distancing.
Yes.
Wash your hands.
No going to the strip club.
She never said that. But what I want to say is the reason why she won't be on the air is because her husband's a veteran and they're out tonight for dinner.
Hey.
So big shout out.
Happy Veterans Day. Yes.
We appreciate you.
Oh, my God. Yeah. Where would we be without
them?
Where would
we be? And I have to definitely.
Freedom is not free.
No,
they fought for us to have this freedom that we have in the United States of America.
Right. We have to listen. I got to say, because I'm a military brat. I was born and raised this way. I lived in Germany for years and everything. it doesn't just become that one person. It's the whole family. The whole family gets affected.
Yes.
A person leaves for many, many months, sometimes years.
Yes.
And that communication and having the family together is extremely difficult during that time.
Uh-huh.
The whole family gets affected.
Yes.
So we want to give a shout out to them and their families.
Yes.
Because my sister left 3 years ago, and I know from being an adult how tremendously it hurt me when I couldn't talk to my sister for 30 days.
Wow.
I have never experienced not speaking to my siblings for that long.
Okay.
I felt like she was gone. I was crying.
Wow.
And just the fact is we no communications for 30 days. You don't see them. When they come out, they are a different person, guys.
Yes,
I don't care what anybody says.
Yes.
I believe
Alma changes you.
Big
time. You do not be the same person that you go when you go back, when you go in. You it's just a totally different mindset.
Yeah, and I get why they have to be set for that.
Right.
But when they come out, they have to come back, and that's such a difficult part for them. And
right.
I've seen it. And
yeah.
This young lady is actually an advocate now and speaks to other people in the armed forces
okay.
about depression and suicide because they dealt with that overseas
yes.
tremendously.
I got to pop in and say this. One of those things about when you go over and let's say you're in a war or you're fighting or even if you leave your family for a while, when you come back, I just feel like, and I think they're doing it now, you have to kind of cool down, calm down, and just work your way back into society.
Right.
I don't think that back in the day that they did that. It's just like we're back home, we have the big parade, you know, we march through the streets, and then everybody goes to their family. There needs to be that cooling down period, that calm down, that, you know, you got to change your mindset
yes.
when you come back from those types of situations.
I agree.
So maybe then do they not have anything for them when they come back? Do they not have a program to bring them back into society?
Well, I think there are things now because there's so much with PTSD, and
yes,
I think that mental health and those things are being talked about a lot more.
But when they came from the Vietnam War and things like that, they just
never spoke about it.
They brought it right on back,
right.
And then a lot of them, and
imagine.
And so you know they brought it right back.
And they were young. Kids, young.
Yes.
When I
so
see
we
them
thank
now,
you.
They're
thank
so
you,
yeah.
everybody who
That's
has
right.
served our country
yes.
and continues to serve our
yes.
country.
Yes. Monique Worrell. That's our girl. She won state attorney.
Congratulations.
Isn't it amazing to have friends?
Congratulations.
That are candidates and actually make it into office?
Beautiful.
And the fact is that they're really for the people. They're really here speaking to local radio stations. They're here speaking to independent radio shows.
Exactly.
And she's coming back to say thank you.
Yes.
Come
but
on.
See, what we have to do now is hold these politicians accountable for their actions. Before, we really wasn't
right.
doing it that strong. Like Black Lives Matter saying that, hey, they coming after Biden. All these things you promised us because we got you in.
Yeah.
We want you to fulfill your promises to the people. One of my main things is the Mexican kids that's on them over in them camps. What we need to release that.
Is it only Mexico or is it immigrants overall?
It's probably
immigrants
I could just say, I don't know if you guys realize this, but this is like a concentration camp that's going on in this era right
and
now,
I don't
guys.
Trust them.
In this era, they're separating the kids from their families, not giving anything for them when it comes to medical care or even education. It's a
and
new era concentration camp, guys.
Filthy conditions.
Yeah, how are we not doing anything about it? Where are the petitions for that? I know Black Lives Matter, but where's that at?
Well,
just saying.
Well, see, the administration that was in office really didn't care about that. That wasn't on their agenda.
They don't have anybody really standing up for them. So as we have Black Lives Matter, we need to have other things of those sorts as well.
Yeah.
We got to really get in, guys, because we can make a difference.
But that's why we hold our new president accountable
that's
for
it.
That. We have to do that. So, you know, it's a good thing. I feel good things coming out of this presidency.
I do as well.
Yeah, and we have to, you know, as people, we have to understand, you know, what a lot of stuff obviously is politics. When we think about immigration, yeah, we talk about Black Lives Matter. We talk about the immigration laws. All of that is relevant. So I think
Absolutely.
A lot of times people are trying to win, let their side
yes.
win.
Yeah.
And so when we talk about, you know, the kids and cages and who started those cages. Yes, actually President Obama built those, but it wasn't for kids to live there.
Yeah.
It was built because once you come across, you have to testify as to why you're leaving your country.
Uh-huh.
And so what they do is they try to separate the kids and the women from the men. And so they're there for like 3 days and then they're either, I guess, approved, moved on or however it works. It wasn't meant for them to stay there forever. And
Correct.
So we have to understand why those those systems were built, what they were built for, what the intention is, and not try to blame either side except for getting the kids back to where they need to be.
We don't care about whoever dropped the ball.
Yes.
If the ball was dropped, it's too late now.
Right.
We can't
get them
fighting.
Where they need to be.
Yes,
exactly.
So we got a full show tonight.
Yes.
This is Angela. We got artists coming in. But you know what? I'm sure by now everybody has pulled their glass of wine. They're just sitting back waiting on the love song
from
Peace on the Streets Radio Show. I'm ready to give them what they want.
Let's do it.
Y'all, so you guys keep it locked to Peace on the Streets Radio Show. I'm your host, Prince of the South. You guys can call in 407-894-1680. If you have any questions for our CPA, our certified financial planner, Reshell Smith, call in, please.
Wealthy Wild Wednesday. Woo-hoo!
Right here on Peace on the Streets. Is the corona affecting our money?
You know... Good evening, everybody.
Hey, Reshell Smith for Wealthy Wild Wednesday.
Yes, yes, of course the corona is affecting the economy. If you are not reading or watching or listening to news about the economy and money, then let me just tell you, restaurants are closing at an alarming rate. People are still filing for unemployment, not as many as were before, but people are still filing for unemployment. People are still needing to stimulate their business so that they can keep people employed. I think that they are talking about another stimulus package, which they've been talking about for a while, but we need it. Let's just be honest. Maybe not us individually, but the economy needs it.
Right.
There are some businesses out there that we don't want to see them go away. We want to patronize them, but it's like a catch-22. Do you go to a restaurant when the corona numbers are so high, or do you stay home and cook? If we're not patronizing those restaurants, they're not making money. They have to cut their employees' hours. And there's just so many things that trickle down when the economy is not doing well. And it trickles down, unfortunately, in a negative way. Now, one of the things that I'm telling my clients is to find a way to prosper in the pandemic. You have to find a way to shift, to find a new income. I've said it on here before. We have been wearing masks for, what, how many, 8 months now?
Yeah.
So if you have a sewing machine and you have some skills or some bling or some something, you should be making masks.
Right.
People are still buying masks.
For sure.
Amazon continues to hire. So you just have to shift. I think that we are in that time where a shift is needed. And maybe what you were doing prior to March of 2020 is not what you should be doing now. Perhaps you can go back to it, but you just have to look at a different way. I think everybody should find a way to start some sort of home-based business. I know it sounds crazy. You could be a tutor. You can be a coach.
Find your field.
You can teach people Spanish that want to learn Spanish.
Yeah.
There's something out there that we all can do to try to find that extra income and provide a service to solve solutions that people need.
You know, that's well said. You know how the wealthy stay wealthy? They're dipped into different avenues of different, you know, receiving different income from different ways.
Yes.
That's it.
Which
definitely helps you within stress. Because of what you said, Reshell, I dipped myself into different, like, three different avenues and retaining money the whole time. I wasn't so stressed out.
Yeah.
You know, with not having the money.
Right.
So it's very important.
Yeah, you have to, in these days and time, you have to be creative.
Yes.
You're going to have to be creative. I'm just saying, in order for you to make it. Because like you're saying, what you might have done in the past, it may not work now. So you got to continue.
Recreate.
You have to shift. Reinvent. The word is shift. Everybody needs to shift. We are
say
in the middle
said.
Of shift.
I like
making
that.
A shift. And I think that everybody needs to consider it. Your 9-to-5 or even your own business, if you have your own business. Let's just say you were a cleaning service and these office buildings now don't really need to be cleaned because people are working from home. But guess what? A lot of places need to be sanitized.
Uh-huh.
You know, so maybe it's not your normal cleaning. Maybe you have to go out and buy that big machine where it sanitizes everything.
Shut your mouth.
And that's your new
hustle.
Thing. That's your shift.
Yeah, it's your
shift. So you just have to be creative, or really, really think about what you can do with what you have to bring in that extra income through a home-based business.
I love
right.
it.
Do you guys know you could get paid to actually how you want to say, they have websites now, because if you actually look on Fox 35 and look at the website, you can go and voice your opinion for other companies that need feedback.
Mm-hmm.
You get paid like $2-3 each. And I saw that on the news. I'm like, that's a great site income.
Survey.
You actually make money off of this, guys.
Right. And you could be the $3 man.
Yeah, so you could go on to Fox 35, guys, check out their website. It actually was released yesterday where you can find legit companies that only ask for your opinion. You could get paid $2 each opinion or 50 cents.
That's a beautiful thing.
It is. I'm thinking about signing up for that. Hey. I'm online anyway, 24/7.
You're online anyway,
you know. Right? That'd be beautiful.
Yeah. I'll let you know about that.
Hey.
Yes. And you know, so let's go right into this thing, because we started out of talking about the election, right?
Yeah.
It's not over. thought that it was over.
Yeah, we thought it was.
States are still counting and
lawsuits. But I thought he got to 270.
He did, but that's being contested.
What the hell?
You know, so it's not technically over. But here's what I want to talk about, because a lot of people look at Republicans, Democrats, and you think, oh, Republicans are rich and they're wealthy and it's all about money and corporate America. And when they're in office, the economy is so great and it does so well. But let me have you pause and go do some research. Okay. I want you to pause and go do some research, because there is data out there that shows you how well presidents have done, how well the stock market has performed under different presidents, going all the way back to World War II.
Okay.
And guess what? Democrats dominate.
Wow.
I believe that.
Democrats dominate.
Yeah.
Because it's not necessarily the president. The president doesn't
it's the party.
Dictate what happens to the stock market. Things have to go through Congress. There are things that may be going on while that president's in office. But the president who has done well with the S&P 500, which are the 500 largest companies in the United States.
Okay.
The president that did the best, hands down, was Bill Clinton.
Okay.
Wow.
They said Bill Clinton created so many millionaires.
Bill Clinton.
It wasn't
interesting.
Funny.
After Bill Clinton, it is Barack Obama.
Look at that.
Because Bush,
Bush, who?
He messed the country
up. But you know how many people said when Trump came to office, how bad Obama did
when
that's in the economy.
No.
Oh, my goodness.
The S&P 500, the 500 largest companies in the United States, that's an index, that's an indicator of how the U.S. economy is doing overall. Under Bill Clinton, the S&P 500 was up significantly, like millionaires, billionaires.
Right.
Then there was Barack Obama, the worst from that time, going back to Truman, to World War II, was George W. Bush. That's little Bush.
Interesting.
He was at the bottom.
I believe
unfortunately.
It.
Wow.
And you know, we had wars and those things going on. So he did have some
mass
things
of destruction.
But let's talk about Trump.
Interesting.
Because Trump is not at the top. He's actually in the bottom, lower half.
Can we say it again? Because I have a lot of people that
he's
are saying.
He's actually in the lower half.
Okay.
And let me just didn't make a disclaimer, but he's only been in office for 4 years.
That's true.
Right. Other people had two terms.
Eight, right?
Well,
eight
some
years.
Of them.
That's true, though.
George H. Bush didn't have two terms. But his first term has him on the lower half, not in the higher half.
Okay. Got
you
it.
Think maybe because he didn't have enough time? For 4 years, is it much?
It's 4 years.
We couldn't take no more.
We couldn't take it.
George H. Bush, Daddy Bush, had one term, right? And
yes.
he's up He's up there towards the top. And a lot of people talk about Reagan, Reaganomics. You know, you always hear Reaganomics. It was Reagan was there, but it's Clinton, it's Obama, it's Eisenhower, and then it's Reagan.
Wow.
Got it.
I'm going to save this. I'm going to send it to all my friends.
That's right.
Because you know how much I hear about how bad Obama destroyed the economy.
Do you know when Obama got the country?
But you got to do your research.
Yes. Absolutely, Reshell.
And you have to remember. I've lived that.
That's it.
Yeah, because I remember the stock market was a mess. The houses.
When he came in, houses, it was horrible.
I mean, it was so bad that they gave it to a black man. That's how I look at it. That's how messed up the country was.
Well, a woman almost had it.
Yeah,
we almost got there.
Yeah.
We're not VP. We're right next to the presidency.
Yeah.
Right.
But
right.
That's only, check this out. This only going to happen up on the Democratic Party. Republicans feel like a woman. And even the women, I heard a Republican woman saying that we too emotional to run the country.
A woman said that?
A woman, Republican.
How funny is she?
Because they feel like it's...
she might be too emotional.
It'd be a man. It should be a man.
That makes sense.
You know what?
I know more emotional men than women at times.
Yeah.
Emotional. The current president is extremely emotional.
Yes.
We got to get a song.
He's so emotional. I said, please don't speak anymore.
So that's the election and the performance under different presidents going all the way back to Truman. Go do your research and get the facts, people.
Reshell, this is huge. Thank you so much. Yes.
Monique Worrell is in the house.
Yay!
How you doing, Monique?
Hello.
Hey, congratulations.
Now, Monique Worrell, ladies and gentlemen, she's been on our show several times. She was running for candidacy for state attorney here in Florida.
Uh-huh.
And she won Orange and Osceola. Monique Worrell,
What's happening?
Hello. Listen, it is such an honor and a privilege to be back with you guys.
I'm so happy that you're back on the air with us to express, how did it feel, Monique, to win? How does this feel? I've never actually spoke to a candidate that won that's came back on our show.
I mean, as a big timer, she ain't no little
Rudy poop.
Yeah, she
I was like, Nico poop.
I am so humbled. You know, this started as a dream. And, you know, you guys remember I came into this race as the underdog. I was the person who they said couldn't do this, that I couldn't win, that it wasn't possible. And now here I am 9 months later and have actually given birth to this dream. And it's now a reality.
Yeah.
But you know what? On the commercial, you went at it hard.
Yes, she did.
You was the only person that I seen on the on TV.
Yes.
I was like, man, your marketing was a beast.
It was great.
So I have to say that those were friends that marketed for me, because a lot of that was not done by my campaign. It was done by, you know, other organizations that supported my run. So I was excited to see it. I, be honest with you, I was at the polls almost every day during early voting and election day. So I never actually got to see any of the commercials.
Oh, wow.
But I heard about them. People would call me and be like, oh, my God, you were just on TV. Oh, my gosh, you were just on TV again. So it apparently worked well.
Yes.
And your billboards was all over the place.
Right? Yeah. Signs everywhere. We even took pictures next to a couple of billboards. We pulled over.
I saw your pictures. Yes.
We love it.
So if you just get in the office, I mean, what is the main thing on your agenda? What is the, you know, the saying, your topic that say that I know that, that you're going to attack? What is the main, you know, your focus?
You know, so there are many, and we're uniquely situated right now because of, you know, COVID. The courts have an 8-month backlog. So one of my first priorities is going to be getting us through this backlog. There are people who are sitting in jail waiting on their court cases to come. And because we haven't had any jury trials and court hasn't really been, you know, operating, these people need to get their cases resolved. So those are going to be my, you know, first priorities. But then it's going to be about changing that culture of prosecution, which is what I promised the constituents that I would do, so that we can begin training our prosecutors to utilize alternatives to incarceration for nonviolent offenders. Mm-hmm. So I'll be working really hard to develop a really rigorous training and development unit that will instill these ideals and values in our prosecutors.
Awesome. We have a question. Go ahead, Ms.
Hi, Monique. Congratulations. This is Reshell Smith, and we haven't formally met yet, but you got my vote.
Hey! Hello, and thank you so much. I appreciate that.
So I am a certified financial planner, and one of the things that people ask me about is investing in marijuana. Which I got that question today here in the station. But my question to you is that in many states, marijuana was legalized to a certain extent. I guess every state has a different amount that you can have and be okay. My question is, for the people who are incarcerated prior to these laws and marijuana being legalized, what happens to them? Because I'm always angry about investing in something that it could very well do well, but I think that black and brown people are in jail for this. And so it's hard for me to want to invest and profit on something that I know people are in jail for.
Yeah, so though that is an excellent question, and I want to start by saying marijuana is not legalized in the state of Florida, so let's start there.
Right.
I attended an event during the campaign, and you could, smell marijuana in the air.
In the campaign?
Law enforcement officers say, based on my training and experience, I smelled what I recognized to be the scent of burning cannabis.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not legal in the state of Florida.
Mm-hmm.
What I have said is that I will not be utilizing the resources of my office to prosecute misdemeanor marijuana cases.
Okay.
Because there are so many things that we need to focus on, and our resources are not limitless, and I don't think that it is a good use of our resources to prosecute something that, one, we've legalized for medicinal purposes,
mm-hmm.
two, is legal throughout different parts of the country,
mm-hmm.
and three, doesn't really have any impact on the safety of our community.
Mm-hmm.
And as prosecutor, I believe my first and primary responsibility is to ensure public safety. And I don't believe that prosecuting marijuana cases does that. So that's the first part. The second part is, a really good question. What happens to all these people who are serving lengthy prison sentences for something that we have now monetized
legalized?
Right.
And I agree with you that it's a terrible thing, and I know that Senator Randolph Racy has been discussing some legislation that would do something for individuals who have marijuana convictions to either work towards cleaning their record,
mm-hmm.
As far as perhaps, getting them out of jail or prison. And that is legislation that I would wholeheartedly support.
Wow. Amen. We love
thank
that.
Thank you. That
you are a girl. See, we've been needing this in office.
And that has been my struggle as a financial planner.
Wow.
That
okay.
has been my struggle when people talk about investing in that. And not only that, and I have to say this just to put this disclaimer out there. In many states, it is legal, as Monique said, but that is the state. It's not federally legal, so you can't be depositing money that you made off of something illegal into banks,
because
that's like embezzlement. That's not federal.
How are we able to invest in stock with marijuana and we can't put in our bank accounts?
Well, we'll talk about that later.
Okay. Interesting.
I know we have another question.
We'll is this a trick? Maybe we shouldn't invest in this right cut yet. Interesting.
Yeah, please don't talk about that with the state attorney-elect on the phone.
Yeah, we're not having that conversation at all.
Right. It is confusing, though. I'm not going to touch that. I'm just going to stick to gold.
Yes, okay. So those are the things that you're going after. And just tell us about your celebration with your family and all that good stuff. Because that's what we never know about when people win. Sometimes we don't know the joy that they came into with the family. And any shout-outs you'd like to give, any people that you like to,
So first, I want to give a shout out to you guys and the Peace on the Streets radio audience. Thank you guys so much for your support, for your encouragement, for, you know, standing with me to this victory, for helping me to get my message out, for supporting me, for, you know, all the things that you did to help me to get to this point. So I just want to say thank you. And that was the main reason that I wanted to come on tonight, was just to say, you know, we did it.
It's a village.
And you see, your voice and your vote matters, guys.
Yes, it does.
And especially at home.
That's right.
Where we're getting
That's
affected right. every single day, and they listen. And we got a lot of younger generation voting
But
now.
You know what I learned, Mimi, with the younger generation? They're not going to be bamboozled. They
yes or not.
What it is. They're not even with the plan.
They're not.
I was talking to young people today, and they was like, we want to hold these politicians
accountable. And they will. They'll call it out.
And so they're not with the old, when back in the days it was different, but we have internet, we have insight. So I love the new generation. Yeah. To all the young
folks.
They
came in this year. Vote, boy.
Man, well, hey, we appreciate the young generation.
Absolutely.
Yes, and then I want to thank my husband for standing by me and supporting me. This was
Gerald LaVert.
Is that an endeavor. And, you know, it took me away from the family, so it was a sacrifice for him to support me in doing this, because it really meant that I was preoccupied a lot in this quarantine time when we're homeschooling our boys.
Wow.
So,
wow.
For him. And then, you know, my parents, they are just amazing. If you voted at the West Oaks Library, you saw my parents, because
I talked to them every single day, holding up signs. Yes, they were.
Waving people in.
Yeah.
I talked to them.
In support of me. And I mean, they worked it like a job. They were out there from 7:30 in the morning till 6:30 in the evening.
Beautiful.
Relentlessly in the rain, in the heat. They are my number one fans, and I love them with all my heart, and I'm so thankful to have them.
That's also amazing.
Great.
I probably did see her parents, because I was there. I did vote there.
Me too.
I did see a lot of people because they were there.
How cool.
Well, when you talk to them, tell them the barbecue guy. Because I had the grill out there. You know, I'm opportunist. And when I seen there was a lot of people there, I pulled the grill until they ran me out. We appreciate you, girl.
Absolutely.
And you're always welcome. And every now and then, when things change and laws change and things that we don't know about that you think that's important, that we should know about, please come on. And let us know what's going on, honey. We want to know.
Like you said, I'm family, and you guys are family, and I will not forget the people who helped me to get here, so I will be back for sure.
All right. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, State Attorney Monique Worrell.
Right here on Peace on the Give us all your contact information. We don't want to be left alone.
You do not want to be left alone. And let me just tell you this. Since I'm here the second Wednesday of every month, I will not be here for Black Friday. Guess what? You better not spend all your money either.
Well, Black Friday is every day
And that's what I was going to say. Black Friday right now is actually every day. Remember what I told you all last year everywhere? If you ever watch me, everybody gets a number. If you're going to give Karen $50 on her gift and John $25, right. on hers right. and Keisha 15 on hers, you stick with your number.
Got it.
Stick with your number.
So don't overdo it.
When you're ordering products through the mail, make sure you ask for a signature. You do not want packages to be left at your door. You know people are following UPS and FedEx to go right behind them and take your packages. Require a signature or get you a mailbox and then have it shipped to your mailbox, and they'll sign for you when they deliver it to your mailbox.
Got it.
Okay.
Did you all see the new, they said the Jetson, where they have the new things like the Jetsons is going to be in two years.
Yeah. So
the drones, you mean?
The drones.
Is that drones? What you mean?
Yeah. They're dropping off packages.
People.
Well, they're starting that out with the villages. The villages started it.
Okay.
They were ones who were going to get their packages delivered via drone.
Okay. Well,
that's drones, not people.
No.
He called it the Jets. Ladies and gentlemen, drones.
What? No, y'all hadn't seen the new thing.
Okay, we haven't.
They drop off packages, not people.
No. No, they're doing the thing like the Jets, and what people getting picked up and flying in the air.
Prince,
I seen it today. I watched the news. I'm just saying, you'll see it.
Is it happening, or is there something they're working on?
Did you make
this
up?
They're working on. No, it's
probably
in 2 years. It's a company called Trivon, and they're working on this where now you're going to be able to fly just like the Jetson. They're saying it's able to get you there quicker than the train that they have and the things like that for transportation. It's in the mix now.
But we could just use a helicopter.
I mean, I can do that because Uber helicopters in, if that's a word, in New York. Like, if you want to go from the airport, JFK, to the city, you can Uber.
Well, they're starting
it
here.
Okay.
And I've seen the where they pick you up in. It looks nice.
So are you got a helicopter?
Are you going to get in like there?
Yeah, I would try it. Okay. I would try it once. But, you know, with me, you know, I'm a landscape. Can they pull the truck and trailer? You know what I'm saying?
But just
to try it, it lifts up and it's just like
I've never heard of this.
It's just like I just seen it today. It just came out.
Okay.
And
so it is out on there. They're trying to.
They're
make
working
it.
On. They say in 2 years.
They're trying to make
yeah,
it.
Yeah, in 2 years it'll be out. You guys, it's amazing. It's,
wow.
It's a beautiful thing. The way they come and they load the people on, just like how you at the train, they load so many people on, and you're there in no time.
Wow.
Yeah, so, hey, they saying the new Jetson is here.
Okay.
So, it's amazing. Right. Okay, but anyway, Reshell Smith, did you do all how we can get in contact with you?
Oh, so I would love for you all to contact me. We're going into the holidays. We're getting ready to start off a new year. Please visit me. All of my information is on my website. If you go to www.reshellsmith.com, that's reshellsmith.com. My phone number is there. You can email me. You'll have a link to my YouTube, to my podcast, to my videos, whatever it is that you want to talk about. That's a great place to start. Or you can email me. Email me at info@reshellsmith.com. That's reshellsmith.com. Or give me a call, 407-258-1062.
And your college.
I'm sorry?
Your college.
What about it?
I mean, we don't know anything about your college. Can you give me something quick about your college? Because I know you're doing something online.
Well, what he's talking about is my academy. She's So Wealthy Academy is what it's called.
Okay.
But if you go to RochelleSmith.com and under Teachable, because I'm a teacher, so remember that, Teachable, RochelleSmith.Teachable.com, you will see all my courses, how to invest in the stock market, what is a stock,
nice.
What's an exchange-traded fund,
okay.
You know, how to help your lazy 401k, because if you haven't been making money over this last week, that's probably a problem, because the stock market is on it's been
really?
Like the Jetsons this week.
Why?
Well, we got some news about a vaccine.
Hey, there you go.
Oh,
right?
Yeah.
So it has nothing to necessarily do with the president. Uh-huh. It's because Pfizer came out and they said that they were doing this trial, and I think it had like a 90% success rate.
Yeah.
And then I think Moderna, if I'm saying it right, they're going to come out with something. And so it's not like we have a vaccine here today, but it's promising.
And the United States saying that they are ready to push it. They're going to be able to get it to so many people. I've seen the process of
the
vaccine.
Too.
It is serious.
They created Viagra, if I'm not mistaken.
They have to keep it frozen.
Yeah.
And they can only, once they lift the thing up, it can only be lifted like 2 minutes. Mm. They have to take so many out to be able to deliver, but they can deliver like 700 at
one
time.
They'll use they'll use the military or armed forces to
and
help.
He's saying he's ready.
Get it out.
Yeah.
So
he said he's ready.
Who?
For the military.
Who's ready?
The military.
Oh, okay. I thought you said he.
Yeah. Well, the guy that's over that division pushing it. He's saying that
well, the guy that's over the whole military is the president of the United States. So.
Well, not him.
All right, he's the commander in chief.
Well, they had somebody higher than him.
Oh,
you know. But the guy saying that we're ready to get
military
it.
Military is ready.
I watched 60 Minutes.
Oh, okay.
You know you're getting old when you watch 60 Minutes.
Yeah, everybody on 60 Minutes is up there.
Yes,
but
so
it's good.
They saying that hey, they're ready to start pushing it out, and when it hits America. And once they get it approved, then it's on the
bottom. But are you going to take it?
I was just going to ask that.
No.
He said no.
What about you, Reshell?
I'm
skeptical.
I don't
do the flu shot. I don't know what you're putting in my body.
I'm skeptical.
And they ain't been too friendly to color people and people, brown people. I don't know what you're putting in my body. That's why I don't do the flu
because
shot.
They've done trials on us before, and we didn't know that it was a trial. So yeah, we're skeptical.
Oh,
that's right.
Wow.
Yeah. Hey, you guys, it's been a hot show.
Woo!
We appreciate Reshell Smith for being on. It's always a hot show when you're in the house.
Now, guys, remember, if you have any questions in regards to finances, please go directly to Reshell, not to Mimi and Prince. I do get a lot of comments and questions. I can't answer this. I'm not qualified. Make sure you go to Reshell Smith, and she'll be able to answer you. We appreciate you.
Yes.
Reshell for Wealthy Wild Wednesday.
She refused to fight.